God cannot be made to suffer. I can't make God suffer. Have you ever, like, had a feud with someone or a situation, and you kind of just want to make that person suffer for a while? I mean, okay, my husband and I got in a fight, and I'm just going to make him pay for a little bit, just a little bit. I'm going to make him dwell in this anguish for a little bit. I can't make God do that. He willingly has chosen to come down to my suffering. I can't cause pain or infliction upon my God or a problem. He chooses to come down and dwell with me in my suffering. It's his choice. He's chosen to do it. And I get to choose to draw near to him or draw near to something else or draw within, whatever it may be. As I said, when I lost my baby, of course, there was a time of mourning, and my family, my friends were amazing. I have a close-knit group, and they were, man, people came over and spoke blessings to us and prayers with us, and I really appreciate it. So along with crazy things people said, there was a lot of really, really awesome things. But one moment that stands out in my head was, it was a rough day, and my little brother had just gotten back, and I was just laying on the couch weeping, just weeping. And he walked through the door, and for whatever reason, my brother is that one person that can make me cry all the time. Like, I don't know why. Wish it wasn't the case. Got him out of a lot of trouble when we were younger. But anyway, he came and he looked at me, and there were no words said, and I was laying on the couch, and he came and sat on the ground beside me and put his arm around me, and he wept with me. And he joined me in my suffering. And we never said a word. We never even looked at each other. He just sat on the floor and wept for hours with me. Never said, okay, that's enough, let's get up. Never said anything. He just joined me in my suffering. And what comfort and peace that brought. And that is what our Heavenly Father desires to do. But see, he's given us such an amazing gift of free choice that it's still our choice to allow him that place in our lives and in that grief. But I will say this, if my brother in a human condition is capable of showing that type of emotion and compassion, how much more is our Heavenly Father? You know, my dad often says that when people are asking, I don't know if they believed in God at the end of their life, and he goes, if I, a human, would show mercy on someone, how much more would God show mercy on someone and then that last breath give them an opportunity? That's our God. He's so much bigger than me. He's so much more gracious than I ever think I could ever, ever be. He's so much more patient than I could ever be. So why do these terrible things happen on this earth? I have to say there's a lot of things I've heard that I don't agree with, but I don't think he lets these bad things happen because you were bad. I don't think I don't think people don't get healed because you didn't have enough faith. I do not think that he's trying to teach us a lesson. That's not my God. That's not who he is. I think, and this is a journey I'm still on and I'm discovering more and more, and it makes more and more sense. And I encourage you, if you want a resource, to ask one of us. We can try to help point you in the right direction. But I think that when he set this all up, he didn't want to be a tyrant. He didn't want to be a demanding, evil God. He said, I so badly want a relationship with them, but I want them to have it. I want them to want it. I want them to want to be with me. It's no fun trying to make someone love you. Been there and done that. That's fun, right? No, it's not fun to try to make someone love you. It's a lot of work and a lot of disappointment. And God just said, I want them to want this. Okay, so if I'm going to do that, there's things that are going to happen in this world that I'm not. I give them that choice, disease can seep in, depression can seep in, stress, anger, resentment, all these things are going to seep in. But he gave us a choice. He didn't put those things because it was punishment or because, here, try to weave your way through this, and if you can get through this and get to me, then we're good. No. It was cause and effect of what was happening. And so if you tell me that the decisions we make as a society affect this planet and affect the climate, and for the years, we're affecting what's going to happen years from now with our weather and with our resources and all that, then you cannot tell me that the decisions and things that we have made in other areas are not going to affect the generations to come. They will. What happened in the garden has affected us. What happened in World War I and II has affected us. What's going on right now in the world will affect generations to come. So just like our choices to take care of a planet has a cause and effect, it will have a consequence, so do the decisions we made. But God gave us the right to make those decisions. He says, I'm here anytime. I'd love to give you wisdom. I'd love to give you direction. It's your choice. Come unto me. I'm here. I'm willing. And you know what? It takes a really selfless God to do that. It takes a really selfless God to say, I'm going to give somebody free will. It's really hard as a parent to give your child free will. I don't think I have that one figured out yet. But a really selfless God gives you the choice. And you get to make it. And you know what? He's okay with it. He honors you. He respects you. He doesn't say, well, you made a wrong choice there. Here is your punishment. Here's what's going to happen. No, he loves you. He respects you. And he says, anytime you want, my arms are open wide and I'm here.